Hey, what's up everyone, and once again welcome back to Super Smash Bros. For Nintendo 3DS. Last time we played through Smash Run for the first time using Mario. I've already switched him back to his regular palette because I already started recording this episode and got confused about how to select things again. And this time we're going to be playing through Smash Run as Luigi, of course in his default costume, not his default costume, with his default moveset without anything altered, without any powers. As for his costume though, we used the Waluigi one last time. So I think we'll go with his fire suit. Let's do it. Alright. It has been a few days since I recorded the first one. Oh, he's telling us about Green Missile right there. Neat. It's been a few days since I recorded the first episode of Smash Run, so I don't really know how we're gonna do. For some reason, I thought that Luigi could wall jump for a second. He cannot. He also feels incredibly slow right now. Is he normally this slow? Am I just crazy? Maybe I'm crazy. I also really like the music they chose. If you guys don't know, this music was used in the Greninja reveal trailer. So it kind of holds a place in my heart. Not necessarily a special place in my heart, but certainly a place. I do not know how to play Luigi. Certainly holds a place in my heart because I thought that was Mewtwo. Everybody thought that was Mewtwo in the Greninja trailer, let's be honest. And this music just brings back the memories of that. Alright, ooh, a secret door already. Alright, let's get in there. Avoid that bullet bill right there. Okay, target smash. This is a new thing we haven't seen yet. Just hit all the targets. Now, it said this was the hard difficulty one. I didn't mean to do that. If you touch the ground while it's like that, you die. I didn't use the down B. I should have used the down B to go further up right there. Why is it giving us all these difficult ones for starting? Well, I mean, you know, technically, I've played through Smash Run hundreds of times. But the game doesn't care. It's just gonna give us all the difficult ones. That is a Kuko! Do not hit the Kuko! You will regret it. It acts just like it does in the Zelda games, and it will attack you, and, well, actually, it acts just like the item in this game does as well. It'll attack you, and it'll be relentless. That's the word. Here we go. Okay, so this is like a timed enemy room. I don't think we've really encountered those yet. But they're pretty fun. They're pretty neat. You just go to a certain area, there's a bunch of enemies to fight, and that is about it. I also, you know what I didn't do before starting recording this episode? I didn't look up Luigi trivia, so I'm gonna have to do that, like, between this and the secondary run. I'll, like, look it up. So, could you jump? There's this little, oh, okay, this, sometimes this rises and then there's enemies on it. It didn't last time. Oh god, I hit the Kuko. Oh, I hit the Kuko! Let's not have that happen again, please. What the hell was I saying? There was that little white arrow, and I'll be honest, I'm not entirely sure what it means. Maybe it means I left a collectible behind and it's telling us about it, or an item by chance, maybe. Yeah, because now there's that white arrow again. Let's get further over this way. Okay, seriously, how do you do... How do you do the rising down special with Luigi? I cannot pull it off for the life of me. Also, I'm going down here because it seems there's some kind of treasure trove thing. A secret room has appeared. So we gotta run real fast and hope we can get down there in time. I think we might just make it. Get up, Luigi. Get up! Stop it! Yeah, okay, so this secret room right here, it's not normally open. There we go, this is the little target room. It just opens up every now and again. Not in every run, of course. Get those, even though they're powers and we don't need them. Excuse me, pea hat. I think that's a pea hat, right? I don't Zelda, but I think that's a pea hat. Could you stop reducing my stats, my guy? That'd be great. So you're gonna keep doing this until you die. There we go. Surprised that actually worked. Got a trophy right there. Oh, bonus time. More stat boosts will appear. I'm down for that. Okay, you need to stop that, my dude. You gotta really... Don't lower my defense, too! Okay. It's fine. It's fine. We're gonna be fine. We're okay. I think our jump is off the charts right now. Well, never mind. He took that down, too. But yeah, it still feels pretty off the charts. And Luigi's already got a decent jump stat. Okay, he fell. Good. Don't you do that. I keep forgetting to jump whenever he does that. Alright, you know, do it again. Okay, I meant when I'm not about to get hit by it. I'm trying to see if Super Jump Punch works. There we go, Super Jump Punch does work. Alright, neat. Got another jump power. I think the stats that guy reduced were only temporary losses, so we should be fine. We already went over this way, but I'm heading back because, yes, secret door down here. We never went far enough down to find that. Alright, defeat them all. Difficulty normal. Alright, Luigi. Okay, these guys can... You gotta grab them. Okay, stop it. I recommend doing your quickest throw. Could you throw? God. I recommend doing your quickest throw to get rid of them the quickest. You can also just throw these guys kind of off the stage. That's a Street Pass quest ghost right there. Those are kind of neat enemies and weird inclusions, but sure. Let's pick up this gold. Again, we don't need it all. And I'm fairly certain I said last time, like, after 10 pieces of equipment on the bottom screen, right there, well, it's beneath the news smash thing right now. We're apparently the richest player, so that's nice. But beneath that, it's... Oh, give me that back! He stole our stuff, and he killed himself. Okay, well, we're not getting that back. We're just gonna... Oh, we got the... Okay, I don't know why I'm trying to go that way. We're probably not gonna get that much more stuff, moving on through here, because... We're really close to the end, we've got 10 seconds. We kind of got screwed over there by that guy taking all of our stat boosts. Oh, he's there again. Right, it's a different one, but still. Alright, can we get one more kill? Probably not. Okay, yeah, we killed that guy. I mean, it didn't get anything for us, but we killed him. And that's always good, right? Alright, let's see. Speed, jump, attack. Speed, jump, and attack are all really high up. I mean, the only person to get into the second row was... Is that Fox? I think that's Fox hiding under there. On his arms, stat, so... I'm hoping... Is it just a fight? It's a team fight. Okay, final battle... Oh, Flower Smash! Okay. I forgot Flower Smash was a thing. To be honest with you. Okay, does everyone just have a flower? Oh, I was looking at the wrong guy. Okay, well, we're already down one. Damn it. Who was I looking at? Lucina, you gotta get out of here. I already cost us, our team a point. I need to get that back. You know, I'm gonna be cheap. I'm just gonna throw her. And then if she rolls back... Okay, not quite. There we go. Alright, that's the point that I lost regained. Damn it. Okay, so basically if you don't know what the flower does, it's, I think it's the lipstick item that normally puts it on your head. Is the lipstick in this game, actually? I don't recall if it is or not. But it does constant damage to you, as I'm sure you can tell from the bottom screen. So we're on real high damage right now, and our defense is low. But there goes Lucina. Alright, we're on 2 points. And they're on, like, minus 2 points. Okay, there we go. Good. We've got hella points right now. We're on stupid high damage, though, so like, yep, there we go. I was gonna say, they could quite easily kill us. Fox just got Lucina, though, so I'm gonna chill up here for as long as I can in my invincibility frames, and then just... Oh, well, actually, Fox might die. Don't kill Fox. Don't do it. Are we good? I think we won that. Hell yeah, we won that. With Fox just chilling there. Alright. Good job, guys. What do we get? We got 3 KOs and one fall, 1 SD. So we ended up, Fox and I ended up with 1 point each, and they had minus 1 and minus 2. Alright, not bad. Oh, hello. Still nothing new, of course, but we got Gamiga from the Subspace Emissary, who does not appear in this game. That'd be kind of a neat enemy to appear in this game. Alright, real fast, I've got to find some Luigi trivia, so one moment. Alright, we're back, and I've got the trivia open. Cool. Alright, so, let's pick a different palette for Luigi for the second run. Let's go with... I think this is based off of his one of these is based off of Wrecking Crew. I think it might be that one, but I like this yellow one. So we're gonna go with that. We're gonna select a new thing. Right here. Okay, and then we're gonna do X for random. Randomly customized, then of course remove the equipment. Because we don't want that. We don't want to be overpowered right now. And then set his specials to number 3, Ice Ball. Throw a slow-moving icy ball at your foes. We have Quick Missile, fly faster and farther than normal, sliding across the ground if you miss. We have Burial Header, can bury opponents on the way down but no critical hits on the way up. And Clothesline Cyclone, a slow but powerful whirlwind slap that sends opponents flying sideways. Okay, and then what powers did it give us? What is that actually? Let's see. Spinning Blades, Smash Extend. Wait, can I click on that? There we go. Allows you to charge a smash attack longer, increasing its power. This basically makes blades appear around you. You have Super Armor and 4 brief invincibilities. Okay. I feel like it could have given us one more, but I'm not too bothered about that. Alright, select you and head on in, Ouija. Let's see how we do here. Telling us about Gordo. I don't think we've seen a Gordo yet. Alright, let's test out these specials real quick. Ready? Oh, there's no enemies around. Okay, where are we actually? Oh, we're way up here. We haven't been here yet. Okay, so we've got Ice Ball, which... Cool. The missile. That is a quick missile indeed. God, I love this Kirby music that it gave it. This is Kirby music, right? I'm fairly certain this is Kirby. We have Burial Header. Oh, I see. So it goes straight down. Let's try that, like, here. Woo! I'm curious if that has a meteor effect as well. Oh, we're still going! Oh, God! That is not what I was anticipating right there. I think I held down a bit too much. All right, and the clothesline cyclone. Okay. Hello, Lakitu. How you doing? All right, so now we've got our powers down there. We'll definitely use those up momentarily. I'm gonna save the smash extend for if we get a special room. You know, for example, the crystal smash. The smash extend could certainly come in handy in there. And I want to make our way back up to where we just were. Yeah, okay, our jump is definitely, like, made worse to start out Smash Runner. All of our stats, I feel, are just reduced at the beginning. Just kind of a pain, but whatever. I want to make our way up to that top left area again, because we really haven't been there yet. We haven't explored everywhere that this mode has to offer. I mean, we're only two characters in, so it makes sense. But still, that's a Kuko. Don't hit him with the fire. Okay, Burial Header actually kind of scares me to use now, I'm not going to lie. Ashes KO'd 10 enemies, cool. That's weird, like, my 3DS at the bottom screen is named TJ Ashwell, but I guess my Smash profile is named Ash? Well, actually, is that a name that I selected? I'm confused. Oh yeah, I think Ghastly can only take damage from projectiles, which... Okay, two ice balls killed him. Okay, I'll take it. Give me that money. Now let's keep making our way up. Hello, Shy Guy. Don't mind me, I'm just gonna completely ignore you. Oh no, I did it again! Oh, even if you just hold down a tiny bit, he's gonna go through. Okay, good. I didn't hold down that time. Get up and stay there. Okay, cool. Here we go, back where we were. Let's just take the spring, it's quicker. Is this where we were? Yeah, okay. Okay, okay. We're not making that. Oh my god, let's take a look at the map. Yeah, okay, it was further over. So, trivia for Luigi. I'm not gonna, like, read this word for word, I'm just gonna kind of paraphrase. I'm also gonna do that so I can see what the heck I'm doing. Am I supposed to be high? Okay, you know what? We're not doing that. We're not gonna go up that way right now, because we've got a bad up special for it. So basically, traditionally, Luigi is always an unlockable character in Smash, but Smash 4 kind of changed that up. Not only was he revealed before the game came out, he is a starter character. Oh, defeat Clubber Skull. Alright, we need to give that a shot, but we can't right now because we're in this fight. We haven't even seen Clubber Skull yet. He's from Kid Icarus Uprising. Also Dark Nut, so that's a thing. You know what? I'm gonna use the spinning blades. That's what they look like. Cool. Okay. We died. Are we close to Clubber Skull now? We're like right next to Clubber Skull. Alright, neat. Smash extend and spinning blades to protect us a little bit. Come on, do a smash attack. Oh, there's that bonsai bill trying to get through. Clubber Skull is scary. Like, real goddamn scary. And he takes a lot, but he's already in, like, his little rage mode, so I think we're gonna take him down soon. I'm gonna use brief invincibility right there. Smash! Smash! Give me that equipment. Come here, bud. Maybe he just always looks raged like that. Could we actually kill him? That'd be great. Clubber Skull is such a pain in the ass to kill. I'm gonna get that brief invincibility again. I'm just gonna keep using brief invincibility. So we can actually get this guy killed. Last brief invincibility. And then I'll use super armor after this. We've only got 20 seconds to kill him. I don't think we're gonna get him. No, don't jab him, Luigi. Hit him with a... Nope, we're not gonna get him. Yeah, I've got a spinning move too, bud. Smash attack. God, he takes a lot of damage. We're not even gonna get him. We're gonna have wasted all this time. Come on, he's... Oh, come on. We totally could have got him right there. All right, fine. Also, Luigi was the first of the four original unlockable characters from Smash 64 to be revealed to be in this game. So, that's nice. Where am I going? I should take a different route. I'm just gonna ride this. Luigi's official artwork is based on his side taunt. Figured that one out pretty easily. Yeah, anyway, that one's just kind of obvious, I mean. Hello. Okay, well, I guess we can't run through you. I don't think we can kill those either, so I'm not even gonna worry about it. Are you gonna take me up? This platform's not gonna take me up. I'll take the bomb, though. Is this platform gonna have anything interesting? We need something to have something interesting, because... goddamn, we wasted a lot of time in this run. Give me those arms. Alright, also, early in development, Luigi could wall jump, however it was scrapped for the final release. The trophy description for Luigi in the North American version of Smash for Wii U makes reference to Ouija, a popular internet meme, apparently. However, it could also be a reference to the number of games where he excitedly refers to himself as Ouija. Alright, I didn't know that. Oh, that's some garbage stats. I didn't realize just how bad we'd done that run. Okay. Alright. Final battle. Multi-man smash. Alright, defeat as many as you can before time runs out. Admittedly, everyone else also has a really low attack stat right now, so let's just see how we do here. So this is basically like Classic Mode's Mii Fighter mode. There's a bunch... why are they so small on the bottom screen? You see that? Like, I didn't edit that way. They're just tiny on the bottom screen. That's so strange. Is that a oh no, that's why. Oh, I forgot this game could do that. Why can it do this but not 8-player Smash? It gives us 5 different ones right there. Well, I guess my question's probably pretty easily answered because 8-player Smash is a lot more than 5. But still, it's kind of neat to see 5 different character slots down there. These guys also die really easily. Throws seem to do a lot. We've got Metal Luigi right there who still died really easily. I'm just going to keep using my throws. Even just the forward throw from center stage is killing really easily. Giant Metal Luigi. Okay. Just need to get a grab on him. Or just hit him with a nut with a me. That works too. He's out. Get rid of you. Professor Oak is still alive. Alright. What else did we get? Did we win? Did we do good? We did! Okay, we still managed to win even with our terrible stats. How much did those guys get? Mario got 23, so he did decent. Toon Link and Diddy not so much, but... Alright, I'm surprised we still managed to pull that off. Ooh, hello. Steampunk get up. And we got level 2 ray gun. Alright. As for the rest of the trivia, Luigi's All-Star Trophy in Smash 3DS apparently remembers his Adventure Mode trophy from Melee, albeit with a different costume. Does it really? Hold on, I gotta check that out. Just because we're in the 3DS version. I went back one too many screens right there. Okay. And apparently, in comparison, his Alt Trophy in Smash for Wii U resembles his official artwork from Melee. Interesting. It is so difficult to find things in this game. God damn it. Alright, let's take a look. Fighter... Where's Luigi at? Oh, we need Luigi Alt. God damn it. Luigi Alt. Oh, it totally does? Wait, what? His All-Star Trophy... That's his All-Star Trophy, his Alt Trophy. Resembles his Adventure Mode Trophy from Melee. Is that really what his Adventure Mode Trophy in Melee looks like? Is it? Alright. Anyway. Let's see. In Super Smash Bros. For Nintendo 3DS, the Luigi with Poltergust 3000 trophy is titled incorrectly? Oh, is it the Poltergust 5000? Hold on. Hold on, let's find that. With Poltergust 3000. Wait. That is the Poltergust 5000! I didn't even realize! Oh! And they never patched that out? Huh. It's apparently fixed in the PAL version. They could just patch that out with an update, surely. Anyway. And then finally, due to the fact that Luigi's head comes forward into the Z-axis when he crouches, he can avoid certain projectiles that go behind his head. Isn't that nice? Anyway, folks, with that is going to go ahead and do it for this episode of Super Smash Bros. For Nintendo 3DS. I know that the trivia sections of these episodes really aren't all that special. I know you guys wanted me to be reading trivia in older series, or older, like, episodes, but there's really nowhere near as much trivia as there was for, like, Brawl or Melee, so I'm just kind of getting it out of the way in Smash Run because we're doing 2 runs, so. Anyways, that's going to be it. So next time, of course, we're playing through Smash Run with Princess Peach. So if you guys enjoyed this video, please make sure to leave a like and let me know what you thought of it in the comment section below. Stay tuned for the next one, and I'll see you guys then.